Good evening and welcome to Trending Tonight. This is the only show on primetime television where we care to explain the news behind the trend. Two top stories that we are tracking at this moment. Story number one is a decision that was taken by the government, or at least announced later, very late in the evening. That is to send a notice to Priyanka Gandhi, Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi, that she has to vacate her bungalow. Now, by law, there is absolutely nothing wrong in what has been done. But now the Congress has come out and alleged that this is a clear case of political vendetta. Is it or is it not? We are going to discuss on the show. Priyanka Gandhi bungalow war, which is the latest Congress BJP flashpoint. The government's action post the SPG downgrade. Many people say it's inevitable. The rule says it's inevitable. Is this a response to Priyanka's sharp critiques of the government? Or is this actually a sense of entitlement? That debate is going to come up in just a short moment. Sense of entitlement versus punishment for anti-BJP barbs. And the Congress also goes on to question that, fine, you're taking action against the Gandhis, but what about M.M. Joshi and L.K. Advani? They're not MPs. Why have they been accommodated in these plush bungalows in Lutyens' Delhi? So that is going to be story number one. Story number two, the World Bank is making an MSME push. We'll have the country head, Junaid Ahmed, joining us in just a short moment. Is it important to unlock liquidity in these COVID times? What should be the strategy in this country to revive the economy, since MSME plays such a crucial role? What really is on the mind of the World Bank? This is going to be our discussion number two. Discussion number one first, let's quickly get you what exactly has happened. So the government has cancelled Priyanka Gandhi Vadra's official bungalow. She's lost her official bungalow. What is the explanation and the rationale? Let's listen to it. Priyanka has to vacate the Lodhi Road bungalow in a month. She's been given time of a month. That is on the 1st of August. She has to do this. If Priyanka stays after the 1st of August, she will have to pay penal rent and damage charges, which means not the official rent, but for overstaying, she will have to pay a sort of a penalty. After losing SPG cover, Priyanka has lost the bungalow also. Now this, the government says, is inevitable because she got that bungalow because she was an SPG protectee. Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi also got government bungalows. They retained their bungalows because they continue to be MPs. Priyanka Gandhi is not an MP. So she does not retain that bungalow. This is the law. This is the rule. In fact, Priyanka owes government 3.46 lakh in dues, is what we have learned from the government. Now, Congress has its own version. Before we go to all our guests, let's quickly play out this reaction from the Congress chief spokesperson, Randeep Singh Surjewala. We'll make you listen to what he had to say, because after about 2 or 3 hours of assessing how to respond on this issue, finally the Congress has reacted. Neerja Chaudhary is a senior journalist with us, Rashid Kidwai, author and visiting fellow of the ORF, and Vivek Reddy, leader of the Bharatiya Janata Party, are all with us. Thank you so much. Vivek Reddy, let's begin with you first. The Congress and their latest allegation is that this is nothing but vendetta politics. You are afraid of Priyanka Gandhi, that she is speaking openly against Yogi Adityanath, openly against Modi. They're questioning the timing of this decision. How do you respond to these allegations?
Well, irrespective of the timing, Sanket, the law is the law. I think the law has to run its course. Priyanka Gandhi is not an MP. If she wants SPG cover, or if she wants less than SPG cover, like Z+, Z- or whatever, all that she has to do is find out her own bungalow and get security. The government perhaps is willing to give the sort of security that she deserves. But the point is that she cannot live on government land. She is not an MP. She has not served the government. She is not in any position such as ex-home minister or cabinet minister. So the rules don't permit it. Why should the rule be different? I mean, India is not a place where we say, show me your face, I will tell you the law. That is how the rule of law has become in India, sadly. And that has to change. And Priyanka Gandhi, I don't know what Congress is up to. Is this some sort of an entitlement that runs generation after generation, from the grandfather to the father, to the grandmother, to the father? and to the children and to their children and to their grandchildren? Does the government have any commitment to maintain them successively for generations? Well, they may have believed that their Congress is a dynastic party and they can control the party. But that is not the way it runs with the government.
Okay.
The government is a place where you serve this nation and you come out. And government is a place where you cannot say that I'm entitled
then,
to this.
Then why does this rule Article not apply? 17. No, one moment. Why does this rule then not apply on, say, a Murli Manohar Joshi or an L.K. Advani, who are not MPs?
Ex-home ministers or ex-ministers who have a certain level of threat, I think they are protected under the rules that are prevalent. If there are no rules to back it up...
No, but then that exactly is the allegation. That, see, you will extend them a political courtesy by not downgrading their threat perception, and thus they will retain their bungalow.
Why doesn't she find her own house and ask for security? Why does she have to live on government property and ask for security? I mean, what is her entitlement to it? She has not been a minister. She has not served this country. She has not been a parliamentarian. What the hell is the Congress trying to do? Is this the sort of entitlement politics that they are trying to demand in this country?
Okay.
They must be shameful of it.
Okay. One moment. Rashid Kidwai as well as Neerja Chaudhary. Rashid, we'll begin with you first. You've heard what Vivek Reddy has to say. He says that this is nothing but it smacks of a sense of entitlement. That the Congress party wants this great privilege, the legacy of privilege to remain. How do you respond to this?
Sanket, I can say this on a political plane. This is a very, well curated narrative that Mr. Vivek Reddy is trying to, narrate. Fact of the matter are altogether different. I'm glad that Neerja ji is here and she's privy to a lot of matters that took place. See, Priyanka Gandhi got married in 1997. That time she was a protectee, SPG protectee, and she was to stay in her in-laws' house in French Colony. Government of the day, that being United Front government, felt that, SPG protection cannot be provided in French Colony house. So a house was given. It was not a house that she sought. In 1998-99, a public interest litigation was moved in Delhi High Court, where Mr. Lal Krishna Advani was the Home Minister. His ministry under Atal Bihari Vajpayee's government gives an affidavit to Delhi High Court saying that Priyanka Gandhi needs this house, justifying the existence of that house because she needs it for a threat perception on security ground. So if at all any rethink at political level has taken place, it is on the part of BJP government of the day. It is not that, Priyanka Gandhi or... I understand, law is as per, threat perception government. I hope and I'm quite confident that government must have assessed threat perception and taken this decision. And in case of Mr. L.K. Advani and Mr. Murli Manohar Joshi, they felt that they are under some kind of threat. So, but it cannot be on political plane. This is a serious matter. See, Rajiv Gandhi was killed. Jain Commission report, Verma Commission report,
So do you feel that this threat downgrade is political in nature? Do you think that this present day threat downgrade is political in nature?
I hope not. I mean, this is not a banana republic. You can't just go on.
Can I just come in?
One moment, Vivek.
Government of the day is very serious when it says that Priyanka Gandhi or Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi, they don't need SPG protection. They must have done. And by the way, this threat perception is not done by, some political entities sitting in television, studios. This is done by, top class, highest level bureaucrats, professionals, input from RAW, IB, all the home ministry. It's a serious matter.
Correct.
Let us not trivialize it. But the way Mr. Vivek...
Vivek, you'll get your right to reply. Yeah, one moment. Neerja Chaudhary, I want to come to you for your opening comment. How do you look at this? Do you think that this is a political decision or this is just a case of a sense of entitlement? Because if Priyanka Gandhi knew that she has been downgraded and this bungalow she's retained only because of her status of an SPG protectee, that status was gone in November 2019. So ideally, she should have expected this.
Yes, I'm sure she would have expected it. Legally, you cannot take exception to this. She is no longer an SPG protectee, therefore not entitled to that house. And that SPG protection was taken away from Sonia Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Gandhi last November. And therefore, the government is on strong enough wicket to say the rule of law must apply. A committee has gone into this whole matter and she must vacate. So to that extent, they are, as I say, you cannot take exception to it. But I would say several questions come to your mind, given the timing of this step when she's been asked to vacate. Mm. And you cannot help wondering, has the timing been determined because the Congress party has been taking on the government, attacking it, whether, you know, the government was caught napping on the LSE with China. They've been particularly strident on the China front that the Prime Minister must answer, number one. Priyanka has been herself very critical of the Yogi administration day after day. And she is the only one in the opposition who's taking on the Yogi government. Akhilesh Yadav, Mayawati, as we know, have been very, very silent on several fronts. So, and even on the COVID front, whether it was the migrants having to go home, whether it's on the economy taking a downturn, it is the Congress party today that has been speaking up.
Okay.
Therefore, you wonder whether this has been done in order to do two things. Is it to send a message to the Congress leaders that if we can get to your top, your mass leader, quote unquote, then we can get to anybody else? This comes to my mind. I may be totally wrong. I may be overreading it, but it comes to my mind.
Okay.
Number two, if it is taken in tandem, in conjunction with what has happened in recent days, you know, an attempt was made to bring down the government in Manipur, and a former Congress chief minister was very active. Now, recently, the former chief minister gets, is interrogated in a case that happened earlier by the CBI. In the last days, Ahmed Patel, again a very senior leader of the Congress party, has been interrogated by the ED.
No, so you're saying that this is coordinated and synchronized, is it?
No, I don't know. I don't know. I'm not saying. But these questions are coming to my mind that if you're getting to the top leaders of the Congress party, and we know how the system works, you know how politics work. In the past, it used to be, you know, a policy of, you know, these are small things, whether you continue in a house or not. It was you scratch my back, I scratch yours.
Correct.
When you are in power, I'll help you. And when I'm in power, you know, this kind of a mutual thing used to go on. That's the kind of politics we have.
Okay.
Under Narendra Modi, that's no longer working.
Okay.
So therefore, one additional point I want to make is this. In probably a week's time, will we see an escalation of the to and fro between the Congress and
okay,
the BJP?
Okay, Vivek Reddy, you have heard what Nirja Chaudhary as well as Rashid Kidwai have to say. Now, your right to reply.
Thank you, Sanket. Sanket, I think it's really funny. I think it's like a Sherlock Holmes, Arthur Conan Doyle story that runs with all the thicket of, you know, conspiracies. That's how Nirja Chaudhary is saying, if that is that, if this is this, I don't know what it is. I don't think Priyanka Gandhi is such a political heavyweight that the government should be concerned about. She has done nothing in politics to prove herself to be some sort of a potent force in Indian politics, number one.
BJP goes hammer and tongs against Priyanka, Rahul and Sonia.
Must establish itself. The rule of law must establish itself ultimately, must emerge victorious ultimately. This is number one. The second, I'm really amazed at Rashid Kidwai. I think he is some sort of a Rip Van Winkle who has got up 20 years ago, who has slept 20 years ago and got up today. He is referring to the threat perception of Rajiv Gandhi's assassination, which occurred 30 years ago, 29 years ago. And like Rip Van Winkle, he sleeps, gets up after 29 years and comes and says, look here, there's a threat perception. There are so many committees that have vetted this and had said that, look here, that perception has blown away. But still he wants India to spend for our security. What sort of conception is this?
Okay.
What sort of mindset is this? I think we should end this.
Okay.
And call the rule of law and say, look here, this is where you have to go to your house. You cannot live at the expense of the state. You have done nothing for the state.
Okay.
This is the problem with entitlement.
Okay. One by one.
Seeing.
Quick response,
Rashid
Kidwai.
Unfortunately, liberals are never
getting
it.
I'm just amazed, my friend Vivek Reddy. What is he talking about? I mean, there was the Atal Bihari Vajpayee government from 1998 to 2004. leave out 10 years of UPA, then from 2014 to 2020,
the threat perception then has changed, my friend.
Last year it was removed. So I'm saying 5 years.
It can't be frozen in time.
Perception remained. And the eyes of government, that's what I'm saying, it's a serious business. It's not on whims and fancies. He's saying, I'm looking at 30 years back. The BJP
in 2014.
If there was no threat perception on her, they should have vacated in 2014. It said 2015, 16, 17, 18, in 19, they said there's no need for SPC
that
cover.
That was 11 years after the incident.
And what about Vajpayee regime?
We are now 29 years
when
away.
That, yes, she's under
not
threat.
Frozen
okay.
in time.
Okay. Okay.
Home Ministry Committee for benefit of Mr. Vivek Reddy, who's not a journalist, let me explain it to you. This threat perception is made on every, 3 months' time. It's not made on a yearly basis.
The rule of law, my friend.
So all this thing,
the rule of law says,
if he applies his mind,
why did
if he
not
uses some contract that he has
okay, okay, run out of time. Rashid Kidwai, Nirja Chaudhary, as well as Vivek Reddy, thank you so much. By the way, there's some news coming in at this moment that this allegation that she did not clear her dues of about 3.4 lakh rupees against the bungalow. There is news coming in now that she has made the payment. So we are issuing this version of the story as well. Thank you so much, Vivek Reddy, Rashid Kidwai, as well as Nirja Chaudhary.